हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू एजुकेशन इटर्निटी। आज के चैप्टर है लाइट।
सो
लाइट मतलब रोशनी होती है, और अब यहाँ पे कुछ प्रॉपर्टीज़ के बारे में बात कर लेते हैं। सो लाइट इज बेसिकली इट इज़ अ फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी। व्हेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट एब्जॉर्ब्स लाइट इट्स एनर्जी इंक्रीजेस। फॉर अस सन इज द अल्टीमेट सोर्स ऑफ ऑल एनर्जी इंक्लूडिंग लाइट। नाउ लाइट ट्रेवल्स एज वेव्स। Have you ever seen ripples in a pond when someone throws a stone in it? Light also moves like these waves. Light do not need any medium to travel. It travels through vacuum at a speed of 300,000 meters per second. Now light travels in straight line. Light always travels in straight line. Have you observed a beam of light in a dark room? You will see it to be straight. This is called the rectilinear propagation of light. Now reflection of light from plane mirror. Now, transparent materials allow the light to pass through them. Translucent materials allow the light to pass partially, and opaque materials reflect the light completely. Now, we are able to see an object when the light falling on it comes back and enters our eyes. The best example of reflection is your image when you stand in front of the mirror. When the light from the luminous body falls on you, your body reflects the light. This reflected light falls on the mirror and gets reflected back into your eyes, helping you see yourself in the mirror. Now, in reflection of light, the angle I is called the angle of incidence and the angle R is called the angle of reflection. The law of reflection states that at the angle at which the beam of light falls on the mirror, which is angle I, it is equal to the angle at which this beam gets reflected, which is angle R. Thus, angle I will be equal to angle R. Reflection can take place from any smooth surface. You will be able to see your image completely or partially in a glass, in stainless steel plate, in pond, or even in a bucket of water. Now, what are the properties of image which is formed by a plane mirror? The image formed will be the same distance, will be at the same distance behind the mirror. The image formed will be virtual. The image formed has the same size as the object. The image will be erect and the image will show lateral inversion. Now, reflection of mirror from a curved surface. So, take a new stainless steel spoon from your mother and you will look into it. Do you see your face? Look for your face on both sides of the spoon. You will be able to see your face clearly on the back side, but it will look inverted. Curved spherical mirrors are similar to the spoons. In a spherical mirror, the reflecting surface is curved. The mirror be thought as a part of a sphere. Now, spherical mirrors are basically of two types. One is concave and another is convex. Concave, if the reflecting surface of the mirror is inside of the curve, it is known as concave. In convex, the reflecting surface is outside of the curve. Now, a concave mirror is called the converging mirror. If a set of parallel rays fall on the concave mirror, they reflect and meet at one point. Hence, it is called converging mirror, and at the point at which these rays meet is called the focus of the mirror. The distance from the focus of the mirror is known as the focal length. Now, convex mirror. A convex mirror is also known as a diverging mirror. This is because the parallel rays of light falling on the mirror appears to converge at point behind the mirror. This point is known as the focus. As the rays appear to meet F, which is focus behind the mirror, the image formed is usually virtual in case of convex mirror. Now, use of spherical mirrors. So, सबसे पहले हम concave की बात कर लें. तो concave mirrors are used to convert sunlight at point it becomes very hot. Convex mirrors are used in telescopes. Concave mirrors are used in headlights of cars and torches. Convex mirrors are used in the rear view mirror of cars. Security mirrors in an area to cover the large area. Now lens. It is with the help of transparent lens in your eyes with which you help to see an image. And the image is formed in your retina of your eye and then you are able to see. Now, you may have lenses often without realizing it. The spectacles, the contact lenses, the magnifying glass, etc. are some example of lenses. Basically, a lens is a transparent curved surface made up of high quality glass or transparent plastic. Lens is basically of two types. First is convex, other is concave. Convex, it is thicker in the middle and thinner at the edges. In concave, it is thinner in the middle and it is thicker at the edges. The center point of a lens is called the optical center, and the line joining the center of two spheres of which two sides lens are apart is known as the principal axis. Now convex lens. Convex lens is called converging lens. The parallel rays of falling of a convex lens converge at a point on the other side of the lens. This point is called the principal focus of the lens. The other one is the concave lens. The concave lens is known as a diverging lens. Rays of light falling on a concave lens are bent away from the principal axis. If you look through the lens, these rays will appear to converge at one point, and this is known as principal focus for this lens. Now, how do lens work? We have learned that light travels in a straight line. However, when light enters from one medium to another, its direction changes, and this is called bending of light. When light enters the lens from air, its direction changes. In case of convex lens, it bends towards the principal axis, since the lens is known as converging lens. In case of concave lenses, it bends away from the principal axis, and it is known as a diverging lens. Now, splitting of light. Not only glass, light can be bent by any medium. Sometimes the water droplets in the air also bend light passing through it. While light passes through the water drops, it splits into different colors. White light is made up of 7 colors. So you see it as a band of 7 colors across the sky. This is what you know as a rainbow. Now you can also observe the splitting of light on a white CD or in the droplets of oil or in a soap bubble. That's it. Your chapter is over. Hope you enjoy this video.